We are assessing progress on a number of issues, including infrastructure, the roads, and the sewer systems and the water issue, and then the drainage system, which was one of the biggest issues. The person who wrote the letter to the president was talking about a town that is forever flooded. No sewerage systems. When it rains, that city is a terrible place to be. One can now see that the infrastructure is now being developed. The roads are under construction, and they are just about to be completed, some of them. And indeed, the drainage system also is being attended to. And I think very soon then those complaints will be gone, because everyone can see that the infrastructure is happening. On the water also, I'm happy that the three reservoirs have now been finalized, because when the president came, there was only one old one on top of the mountain, but there are three that have been constructed now. And the issue of the water shortage has been addressed. Obviously, the issue of connecting every family with a water tap is going to take time, but at least when they go to the communal taps, there's no more shortage of water. So I think that was the complaint at the time. And as the city grows and then its economy grows, they'll be able then to take the tap to the home. And people will be affording to pay for the water, because once you demand the water in your home, you must know therefore that it goes with the responsibility of paying. So therefore the economy of the city plus the infrastructure will be able then to make the city to grow economically, because with the new roads, it means those who want to invest in the area will now be attracted to come, because the roads are better. And then the infrastructure of water is there. They will not run short of water as factories. And then the electricity is still an issue, but they are addressing it, where the substations were not able to cope with the demand. But they've now engaged with the Development Bank of Southern Africa. And once those negotiations are done, they'll be able then to get all the money from the Department of Energy, instead of getting it annually in batches and pieces. They'll get all their money via DPSA, then fast track the installation of substations so that the electricity supply is resolved.
We are so impressed as the municipality of Mzimkhulu by this visit of the deputy minister, because in a way he is assisting us a lot. You remember there are a lot of issues that were raised by the members of the community to the president, and then the president responded and also assisted us together with the province to address those issues that were raised. In a way, we are through now with those projects that were actually identified as the challenge. More than that, the visit, hence it is about the issue of performance monitoring and evaluation. You will know performance monitoring and evaluation is not only to monitor only or just policing. Where there are challenges, we are benefiting as the Mzimkhulu municipality, because where there are challenges, the government will intervene in a way and assist us, because all this is meant to actually improve the service that is being rendered to the people by the government, so that at the end the people benefit accordingly from their government. So far we are so impressed, and I'm quite confident to say that as the municipality, we have made tremendous strides and improvements in the municipality in terms of trying to be in line with the expectations of the people. We have taken Deputy Minister to the roads that are being constructed right in town, hence we are locating the town away from the flood line zone. That will also assist the Mzimkhulu. Our social cluster departments are so scattered in Mzimkhulu, and in a way that actually disadvantages our vulnerable people to access those services there. You have got SASA right across the river, you have got social development temporarily located right up there in the FET. On the other side, we have got home affairs temporarily located in the mall. They are so scattered, it makes things difficult for the people to easily access these services in a day. Hence, we remember each and every department is in a way depending to the other department in order to make everything accessible for that particular person to get those particular benefits.